ke desa untuk mencari nasi. Pada suatu hari, ibu dan kedua anaknya pergi untuk mencari nasi. Anaknya diletakkan di sebuah batu yang datar. Lama-kelamaan, sang ibu tidak menghiraukan kedua anaknya. Jadi anaknya dibawa oleh batu golok itu ke atas langit, semakin lama, semakin tinggi, sampai mencapai awan. Tetapi sang ibu tetap tidak menghiraukan mereka. Saat ibunya berpaling, kedua anak itu sudah ada di atas. Lalu ibunya berdoa untuk mengembalikan anaknya lagi. Tetapi anaknya sudah berbentuk burung. Kedua anaknya menjadi dua ekor burung. Begitu.
Oh, that was a good story, I think. From Nusa Tenggara. Anak yang jadi burung. Oke deh. Guys, teman-teman yang lagi pada itu pengumuman yang soal ngumpul daftar nama tadi bisa dikumpulkan dengan saya di dalam kelas di ruang sekretariat. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, this is Dea Farinanjan for you guys. Good luck, Dea.
Thanks, Kak JJ. Good morning, all. Once again, good morning, all. Good morning, everybody. Good morning, judges. Now, I want to tell you about a story. The title of the story is Golok's Story. The story like this. Long time ago, at Paramauseri in Nusa Tenggara, there lived a poor family. The white man, Inak Lembain, and her husband, named Amak Lembain. They lively helped at agricultural robberies. Every day, they walked to village. All her strength to pound rice. If Inak Lembain pound rice, she came with her two children as well. One day, she was busy pounding rice. Both children placed on a flat rock near where he was. Surprisingly, when Inak began to pound, the rock where they sit moved up more and more, feeling like remote. Then the elder son started scaring his mother. Mother is the hidden sound. But unfortunately, Inak Lembain was busy working. I'm sure, my son, just wait dinner. Mom was spending. That happened repeatedly. I'm sure, it's increasingly rising to more than a coconut tree. The two children then screamed uncontrollably. However, Inak Lembain keep busy pounding and winnowing rice. Siren's voices were getting more and more faint. Eventually, the voice was not heard again. Golok's tone was increasingly high, up to bring the siren reach the clouds. They were crying uncontrollably. Just when Inak Lembain realized that her children are gone. They will take up the song Golok in a combined song and then she prayed to the return his sound. Her prayer was answered. She was given magical powers. With his belt, he will be able to call off the song Golok. Miraculously, the song was cut. With his belt, she prayed into the three parts. The first part falls in a place which later was named the village Gembong, or because the soil they are quite thin. The second part falls in a place called Sun Dasan, because there are people who witness to fall a fragment of this sun. And the last slip fell somewhere rumbling noise, so the place was named Montong Teka. While the two children have no feather to eat. They have turned into a two-tailed bird. The eldest turned into a bird kekuo, and the sisters turned into a bird kulit. Therefore, both derived from humans. The two birds were not able to incubate their eggs. I think that's all. That's my story. Thanks for your attention. Goodbye. Good morning. Oke, buat Kak JJ panggilannya.
professor. Thank you for Dea. Yeah. Oh, sorry judges. I got headache. I think. Okay. So Dea, the story is from Nusa Tenggara, right?
Nusa Tenggara where?
Yeah. Biasanya tuh di setiap cerita daerah itu biasanya ada pesan moralnya. Kalau pesan moral yang ada di dalam cerita itu apa yang bisa diambil? Apakah jangan meninggalkan anakmu di batu? Atau rawatlah anakmu, jangan dibantu dirawatnya? Oh, wow.
Misalnya, kalau kita bekerja. Kita bekerja tidak usah porsi semua tenaga. Jadi kita harus ingat juga apa yang terjadi di sekeliling kita. Kita harus mengingat apa yang mereka lakukan. Karena itu berpengaruh buat kita.
Oh, jadi itu pesan untuk jajah-jajah yang sudah jadi mama dan jadi papa ya? Jangan terlalu sibuk. Oke deh. Pesan moral yang sangat bagus harusnya para ibu dan bapak guru yang menonton di sini. Ini mau hiburan dulu jajes atau langsung? Oke. Okay. Untuk mempersingkat waktu, kita langsung panggil peserta nomor 11, Nurani Rafdita P. Nurani